grass withers, the flowers fade.
Yes, sir.
Word of my God shall stand forever. Amen.
Amen.
I want to talk for a few minutes about the King's table.
All right. Amen.
I want to talk about the King's table. This time of the year, there's a multitude of invitations that are going out. Prom invitation, graduation invitation, graduation party invitation, graduation party after party invitation. Invitations, graduation dinner. Invitations to the commencement exercise. Invitations to bring a gift. Invitations to bring a card that has content. Invitation. They abound.
Yes, sir.
Particularly at this time of the year. Any of you are thinking right now that you have already received an invitation. Many of you have already decided that you ain't going. Then some of us have already inked in our calendar that we're going to be there. Because somebody thought enough of us to send an invitation. You ever have somebody show up at your event that was not invited? When we were coming up, we had a word for them kind of folk. They were party crashers. They came crashed, and then they wanted to come crash the party. But I can remember in my own experience showing up at the party to where I didn't receive an invitation. Just kind of felt out of place. Like a wallfly. Some folk had nerve to give you the "what you doing here" eye. You didn't get an invitation.
Help Lord.
Invitations are stipulations. Some have stipulations in that.
They
want you to do what they entail for you to act when you get there. You don't just receive an invitation to a fight party dressed in a tuxedo. Just out of place. But God, brothers and sisters, has extended to us an invitation.
Yes, sir.
And he's extended an invitation to us not just come and sit and look. He's extended an invitation for us to come and partake. Come and be a part. He didn't just extend to us an invitation to come to the room. He extended an invitation for us to come to the table. Come on to the King's table. That's an invitation that you need to take serious. Because everybody's not getting an invitation to the King's table.
All right.
I mean, you're somebody when you get an invitation to the king's table. You're an elite crowd that you possibly didn't even know that you were able to be in that crowd. But a God that sits high and looks low and know what you and I stand in need of before we ever have the desire itself. He is the one, and he alone is able to fulfill that need. I come to share with us this morning just briefly how important it is that we recognize this great and grand invitation that God has extended to us. And listen, and we are responsible for how we respond.
Amen.
How do you handle an invitation from the Lord? Do you really just snub your nose up and say, I ain't coming? Well,
Lord help
us. I don't want to be there. That says something about a lot of people today. Amen.
All right.
Come to church Sunday in and Sunday out as if they really don't want to be there. When God is so gracious,
yes, he is,
kind and merciful, giving us a brand new day. A day that wasn't promised to us. A day we'll never see before. Yesterday is gone.
Yes, it is.
Tomorrow not promised. All we have is right now.
Right now.
I tell you, there ought to be some right now people that gather in the house of God and say, God, I so do thank you for considering me this morning to be on the invitation list. I'm talking about the king's table. King's table. Yeah, it's not Papa's table. This is the king's table. This ain't a White House table. This is the king's table. This is the king's table. And I mean, the king's table is like no other table. Are y'all with me right now? Oh, yeah. It just makes you, it should cause you and I to say, Lord, in a rejoicing response, I thank you for that. Because you didn't have to do that for a little old wretch like me. But I have received an invitation from my God, King of Kings, Lord of Lords, one who was and who is and who is to come. That's my King. And he has a table prepared just for me. Oh, Lord, that's good news.
All right.
Some of us want invitations to another kind of table, and we can't get that. Amen. Folks got walls up. They got perimeters up. They got vices up. Not to let give you an opportunity to sit at the table. And that's all we really want is just a seat at the table. Just a seat, that's all. Don't have to be top seat, just a seat. Amen. Just let me get down to the table. Don't have to have it all duty up, just let me get there. Watch God, brothers and sisters. Watch God work a miracle in the dynamics of that invitation. Are y'all still with me? And I'm talking about the king's table. Some of you may not really understand what the king's table is all about. Well, let's kind of look at a little historical context. Are y'all with me here? Originally, table comes from the word tabula. We get our word tablet from that. And early on, the table was not meant originally in its inception and design. It wasn't meant for something that you ate on. Amen. But it was designed for something that you wrote on.
All right.
The Ten Commandments are written on tablets. Flat surfaces. Are y'all in here with me? And then you recognize that the that's through the process of time and specification that the table was never meant originally for something to eat on, but through the process of time, it became an article of furniture. And from an article of furniture, amen, to where now you eat from the table. But some of you looking at me right now, you know full well, yes, we eat at the table, and but there are other times when we do what? We write at the table, yeah. Maybe why the inscription is on this table, that whatever and however, whenever you do it in remembrance of me, yeah. You don't hardly see any writings on any other table unless some kid done took an object and carved his initial on top. Y'all ain't helping me. And you know, when they do that, they create all kind of, amen, redemptive responses and retribution in the heart of the one that owned the table. Because I dare you carve something on top of this table, amen, where we eat at. But amen. But we know, brothers and sisters, that that was not the original intent for the table. And Luke says, in essence, that God has so designed, amen, the table for himself. Are y'all with me there? It was merely a horizontal object with a flat surface. That's the table. Are y'all with me there?
All right.
Then when we get to Da Vinci and his rendition of the Last Supper, and we see a table that's elevated real high, and men or the disciples sitting behind that table. Well, that picture is really not accurate. Come closer. Because in the Afro-Asiatic context and culture of that era, those tables would be very low to the ground. Come on, somebody. Huh? In other words, that's why when you see it in its actual rendition, you see the disciples, amen, were laying, amen, on a, help me somebody, on a table, amen, and they were laying on what we used to have in Palestine, Miss Emma, we called it a divan. They were laying on their divan. I ain't got no help. Y'all don't know what divans are. And ain't nothing you die on. It's something you lean on. They would lean on the divan, and the table was so low on the ground where the head of John was in the bosom of Jesus. Are y'all with me there? Each one of the disciples, they would extend themselves when they were propped there. Yeah, they would prop their heads up with one on the elbow, and then they would dip with this hand, and their feet would go away from the table. Y'all ain't saying nothing. And every time I see that picture hanging up, Mama had one hanging up in the house right now, and I look at it sometimes. I say, you know, that picture is really not biblically accurate. Because, amen. But we have them, right? But it's something about understanding what that table actually represents. Are y'all still with me here? He said he recognized that John, Luke says, in no uncertain terms, in chapter 22, here they are. They're coming to the table. And the Lord would say, even in the upper room, they were going to come to the table. Yeah. The U-shaped table. Yeah. Where they had the dates and the nuts and the bitter herbs. Yeah. Yeah. Cups of wine that they would consume. Yeah. They would ingest these elements. Amen. As identification with their Lord and Savior. We come to the table the first Sunday of every month. We don't impart, we don't bestow upon the elements as being actually Christ's body. We simply say,